Finally meet you.
You too.
So, how long have you been living in the city?
About 18 months, I think. It doesn't feel like it's been that long.
I've been living here 3 years. It's a great city.
Oh, definitely. So what do you like most about it?
What do you like most about living here?
My dog in the park, especially on a pretty day.
Yeah? Is that the truth? I have this thing about riding my bicycle around the park. Around the city when the traffic is light, of course.
Oh, same here.
Oh, and also, and this may be just me, but I have this thing about walking my dog in the park on a pretty day.
No, I like that too. I said so earlier.
Do you like watching TV?
No, I...
Me too. I love it.
Are you listening to me at all?
Sometimes I just like to curl up with a bag of popcorn and chow down while I watch Home Improvement. Do you like Home Improvement?
You really are. Listen to me.
Me too. That's right. Tim Allen just cracks me up.
Oh my God.
I mean, his comedy is just choice. It's like his comic timing is a gift from the gods. You know? You know what I'm talking about? Man, I'm just blown away every time I see the show or one of his movies. Have you seen The Santa Claus? Oh, if you haven't, you gotta go and rent it right away. That is one funny guy. He reminds me of me, actually. We have the same sense of humor. My old roommate, Bill, he says that I'm one of the funniest guys he's ever met. Hey, he's entitled to his opinion, right?
Yeah.
Anyhow, I've got my personality flaws.
You don't say.
Sometimes I'm just too funny. People just don't realize when I'm being serious. Do you believe that?
No.
But geez, enough about me. I'm going on like a modem out here.
Oh, no.
Tell me about you.
Or we could just end this date right now since you're the biggest two I've ever met.
Actually, I'm a Capricorn myself.
Oh, this is a speed date.
Yeah, it's speed date.
Hi.
Hi.
It's great to finally meet you.
The same here.
So,
Before you... Sorry, this is so rude, but the Bears game is on right now. You don't mind if I check the score?
Sure, totally.
This is such an awful thing to do on a first date, but it's late in the fourth quarter and it's do or die if you want to make the playoffs.
It's no problem, really.
Thanks. I love the Bears. They're really strong this season. Okay, I'm done. There, that wasn't so bad, was it?
No, but what's the score?
Packers by 7.
Uh-oh.
Nah, it's no big deal. It's just a game, right? So come on, enough about football. Let's hear about Mr. Mystery. Harriet's told me tons about you.
Oh man, the pressure's on now, huh?
I'm just gonna check on the game one more time.
No worries.
You don't mind if I put this little earpiece thing in, do you? It won't be distracting, I promise.
Sure.
I'm making the worst first impression, aren't I?
No.
It's just because it's the playoffs. I'm usually pretty normal.
It's really normal.
Ah!
What?
Oh, nothing. The line on a gives A-train is huge running lane, but but he fumbles after 2 yards. The ball rolls out of bounds, so we're cool. But come on, it's for the playoffs. He don't just drop the ball like that, you know? Now you're 3rd and long, and this whole season is riding on this one play.
What?
Pass the ball! Miller. He doesn't pass it. The man refuses to pass the ball this season. It's 3rd and long. Who hands it off on 3rd and long? Is he suddenly afraid of his receivers?
No.
Oh my God. I'm really loud, aren't I?
No.
Oh, I am. I'm so sorry. Look, how about this? After dinner, I'll buy you dessert at this tiny little bistro on 11th that nobody knows about. It's got to be one of my absolute favorite places to go. It's so precious. I think it was pass the ball! Jesus, people! This is football! Not free tag! Come on down, pass the ball! The ball! The ball!
Hey, listen, I have to get my TV if you like.
No.
Are you sure?
No, I wouldn't want to do that to you. The game's basically over. Okay, I'm done. I kind of carried away there, didn't I? Let's order.
So, how are you
today? Oh, God!
Or, we could order something else. I think the man just tore a little bit.
Oh, they lost! They lost! They blew the playoff!
Oh, my God!
Oh, God!
I'm sorry, is there something I can do?
Oh, my God!
Okay, sure.
See, because here's the thing.
My parents are having a housewarming at their new place on August 2nd, and you and I, like, hit it off tonight and end up, like, seriously dating, that party would be the perfect opportunity for you to meet my parents. So, naturally, I'd like to squeeze in several happy-sized dates before then. If we don't, my parents might be skeptical of our relationship, which could, in turn, prove disastrous for our future together. When you eventually pop the question. Not only would it make my whole family uncertain and uncomfortable during the ceremony, but it would most likely carry over to our 14-day honeymoon in St. Martin. And even more importantly, it would be just awful if you had to deal with skeptical in-laws in the years down the road, and all because of a little thing like not setting a size 14 healthy size date before the housewarming party. And think how a family conflict like that might affect little Jocelyn. Jocelyn! Her little darling. Middle child. Brian first, then Jocelyn. And of course, little Madison.
Wow.
What's wrong? You don't like the name Madison?
No, well, I mean, yeah, Madison's a great name.
Something's wrong. You can tell me. Remember, you're talking to your little sugar pumpkin.
You just seem to have our whole relationship figured out, and we just met 30 seconds ago. I mean, you've got everything pinned down about the wedding dress.
Does that make you uncomfortable? Because if it does, we could pick it out now!
Great. So,